up holy hands. I came to lift up holy hands. I don't know what you came to do. I don't know what you came to do. I came to praise you.
Your neighbor and tell him, I don't know what you came to do, but I came to praise the Lord. I came to praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Isn't it an awesome privilege that we have that we can come to the house of God and join with our brothers and sisters like Precious Faith and lift the name of Jesus above every trial, every storm, every sickness, everything that we have faced during that week, and put his name above it all. Oh, listen, David said, oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. Hallelujah. Give him a big hand clap of praise this morning. Glory to God. I just might preach right now. I don't know. Praise God. Exalt his name above it all. Glory to God. Amen. Hallelujah. Well, glory. We have a few announcements we need to make here. First of all, we need to see all the nursery workers after the service this morning. All the nursery workers, we need to see you pronto right after the end of the service. Also, WM's Mother's Tea is Saturday, May the 13th at 10 a.m. in the Fellowship Hall. There's a sign-up sheet in the back, or you can see Sister Kaylin for more information. Also, the Prime Timers trip to Branson will be June the 1st through the 3rd, going to see the production Esther. There's a sign-up sheet on the back table. We need to know very quickly who is interested in going. So there is a sign-up sheet. If you would be sure and sign up on that sheet before May the 17th. We need that information. Also, Primetimers outing May the 19th, going to Sheridan to shop the flea markets and to eat out. The van will leave the church at 9:30. We'll leave the church at 9:30. And there is a sign-up sheet on the back table for that. Women's Ministry Conference, September the 22nd and 23rd, is $50 a person. Sign-up sheet on the back table. The deadline is May the 21st to sign up for that. Or you can see Sister Kaylin for more information. Also, it's so awesome that Hayden has went through the ranks and had been chosen to go and to represent Arkansas, at the General Council in his fine arts. And so we will be in the process in the next few weeks. We'll be doing some things to try to help Hayden and also his support group. There'll be some fundraisers, in other words, to help them to go to General Counsel on the to present his art. And also, They are selling memorial cards to be filled out and to be taken to the courthouse square during the month of May. There will be flags all set out on the memorial, courthouse yard. There'll be flags set out there, and those cards will be exhibited out there. So if you would like to purchase one of those memorial cards to fill out in honor of someone anyone that you would like, then you can do so, and it's $10. And you can see Pastor Dylan, or I think you can, and Sister Janet as well, to get those cards. And so the profit on this will help Hayden and his support group to go to General Counsel. All right. Well, glory. Amen. Now the main event. Let's have church. Amen. Amen. Let's have church. Glory to God. You know, we do a lot of fun stuff during the week, but I'm telling you, Sunday's the main event. Amen. This is the main event. Praise the Lord. Would you stand? Let's invite the presence of the Lord. So good to have each and every one of you in service today. Amen. Did you come expecting something from God? Amen. I come expecting miracles, amen, to take place in our service today. Praise the Lord. Gracious Father, we ask you, Lord, to come and to be with us, oh Lord, in this service. I pray, God, that you just move and minister mightily, oh God, in this house. Oh God, our eyes and our ears are open to you. And Lord, we ask you, Lord, to anoint every song and every word that's spoken and touch every heart, oh God, that has come here today. Minister, oh God, in this place, and we'll give you all the praise and all the glory in Jesus' precious name. And everybody said, amen and amen. If you would turn around and give everybody a big howdy wave as Sister Lisa comes this morning.
Friend like the lowly Jesus, no, not one, no, not one. None has healed all our souls' diseases, no, not one, no, not one. Jesus knows all about our struggles. He will guide till the day. Like the Lord.
upward way. New heights I'm gaining every day. Still praying as I onward bound. Lord, plant my feet on higher ground. Lord, pick me up and let me stand. My faith on heaven's tableland. A higher plane than I have found. Lord, plant my feet on higher ground.
Heart has no desire to stay without the rise.
Given us some higher ground, amen, above all of that old stuff, amen. We want to go to the Lord in prayer this morning. If you would stand for to present these to the Lord. We want to continue to remember Betty Rogers and Carolyn Ott's, Ruth Robertson and Sister Loretta Hughes had hip surgery this week and is doing great. Continue to hold her in prayer. Also, Carol Klein had surgery this week and is doing well. Also remember Patsy Bailey, Vincent DiGiulio, and Buddy Hammond. Talked to Buddy this week, and he's just doing great. That's Chad and Devin's dad, and doing a great. And so continue to hold them up in prayer. Janice Johnston and Emery Jeffers needs our prayers. And Sister Brenda had a little surgery this week, and so keep her in your prayer as well. Amen. If you have a need this morning, would you lift your hand? The Lord knows your need and your situation. Let's join together and present these to the Lord. Gracious Father, we come, Lord, on behalf of your precious word. Lord, you, O God, have proclaimed and, Lord, said that, Lord, the healing was the children's bread. Lord, it belonged to us. Lord, it's your will that we prosper and be in good health. Lord, you said, O God, and received your stripes upon your back, Lord, for our healing, O God. And so, Lord, upon that confession of faith, we proclaim healing and miracle-working power, Lord, upon these, O Lord, today. Lord, that you would reveal the virtue, O Lord, that flowed from the hem of your garment into the woman with the issue of blood. that brought complete healing into that body. Lord, I pray, oh God, a sudden urge, oh God, of your healing virtue, your power and your anointing, Lord, to move upon their lives and move upon their bodies right now in the precious name of Jesus. We stand against infirmity. We stand against the trials and the circumstances of life. And Lord, we proclaim, Lord, that with your stripes we are healed, oh God. And Lord, that you supply every need according to your riches in glory, oh God. We thank you, Lord, for that promise. We thank you for those provisions, oh God. And Lord, we pray that you'd minister to every need that's represented in this house. For Lord, we glorify you above it all. We lift you above it all, oh God, and we know that you're faithful, and we receive it by faith in Jesus' precious name. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Worship the Lord this morning. Well, I am covered, covered, covered by his blood, walking by faith, living in love. I am covered, covered, covered by his blood. Jesus has rescued me. I am covered, covered, covered by his blood, walking by faith. Satan has no hold on my life, for I can speak the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, he still comes knocking when he can. Oh, but I have been covered by the blood of the Lamb.
I am covered, covered, covered by his blood, walking by faith. By his blood, walking by faith, living. Your very This is my daily bread.
Lord, we want you. No one else will do.
it can happen. With Jesus, it can happen in this place. With Jesus, it can happen. With Jesus, it can happen. With Jesus, it can happen in this place. Chains are broken, eyes are open.
Working God. You are the great I am, the Alpha and the Omega. You're the great God that begun of, Lord, our faith, the author and the finisher of our faith. You're the one who begun a good work in us, and you'll see it through to the end. Lord, we know that you, O God, are a God of miracles. You are a God of amen, yes, and amen. And so be it. You're the one, oh God, who split the Red Sea. You're the one who brought them out on dry ground. You're the one, hallelujah, Lord, that was in the fire with the three Hebrew boys. You're the one who brought Daniel out of the lion's den unharmed and untouched. Oh, you're great. You're great this morning. You're great this morning. Hallelujah. 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 Listen, I just feel in my spirit. Amen. If you need a miracle from God, if you need a divine intervention, amen, in whatever area of your life, financial, physical, spiritual, relational, whatever, God is in this place. He's in this place. He's in this place. And I believe a miracle can happen. I believe a miracle can happen. Just listen to this. There's a story in 2 Samuel chapter 23 and verse 9. A man of God, a mighty man of valor, one of the three of David's mighty men, by the name of Eliezer. He had fought with David. He had been in battle alongside King David and had saw the battles and won victory after victory and victory after victory. And so David began to disciple them and began to pour into them and began to speak the blessings of God and show them the victory of God. Until all of a sudden there was something happened to these misfits and all to these that had joined themselves to David. And they began to be men and women of faith. They began to, amen, fight the battles of the Lord. But on this day, Eleazar, amen, was left alone. He was by himself. Amen. And all of a sudden the enemies surrounded him. The enemy surrounded him. And so Eleazar, he didn't even think twice. After being discipled by King David, after, amen, seeing the victory and being in the presence of God and being used in the glory of God, the Bible said he reached down and he picked up the sword and he began to fight the enemy. He began to fight, amen, all by himself. And he kept fighting and kept fighting. And God's anointing, God's power began to move upon his life, just as it did when he was in the presence of King David. Just like it did when he was joined together with all of them. Amen. He was by himself, but he was stepping out on the power of God and the glory of God. And he was swinging that sword. He was fighting the battle of the Lord, and God brought victory after victory and victory after victory. And the Bible said his hand grew weary. In other words, amen, his hand got tired holding on to that heavy sword and swinging that sword. But something happened, amen, as his hand grew weary. In other words, I believe God stepped in, and all of a sudden, amen, the sword that he was holding, amen, all of a sudden began to hold on to him. Glory to God. It began to hold on to him, and he couldn't put it down. He couldn't get his hand off of it. Oh, listen, saints of God, the sword of the Lord is the word of God. The word of God is a two-edged sword. It's sharper, amen, it's sharp, and it is strong and mighty to the separating joint and marrow, and the discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart. What I'm trying to say is, if you'll get a hold of the word of God, amen, and be faithful to the house of God, and let the glory of God, the anointing of God, the presence of God get a hold of you, amen, then on Monday morning, on Tuesday morning, on Thursday morning, on Saturday morning, when you're all by yourself and the enemy comes in like a flood, the Lord will raise a banner against him, and you can take that word and begin to confess and profess the word of God over your situation. Hallelujah. Oh, listen, saints of God, pick up the sword this morning. Pick up the sword, amen, that God has promised over your situation and over your life. I don't know if it's healing. If it's healing, glory to God, it says with his stripes we are healed. If it's provision, he said he would supply all of your needs according to his riches and glory. It don't matter what it is. If it's being needing to be delivered from something, the word says thanks be unto God who always causes us to triumph in Christ Jesus. Pick up your sword this morning, amen, and begin to confess that sword over your situation and over your life, and keep confessing and keep believing, keep confessing and keep believing until, glory to God, the word gets a hold of you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. They said they had to pry his hand away from the sword. They had to pry his hand away from the sword. Listen, God has a word for you. God has a word for your problem. And you need to search out and get that word for your situation and take a hold of it. Take a hold of it and get up on a Monday and begin to confess that word over your problem. Amen. Get up Tuesday morning and confess. Amen. Read that word. Amen. Out loud to your problem. Read that word out loud to yourself. Because faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Oh, listen, Eleazar, he just got an attitude of faith. There was something happened on the inside of him, and he got an attitude of faith. And he said, not today, devil. Hallelujah. Just like Shammah, hallelujah, was out there tending his pea patch, and the enemy came. He stepped out in the middle of that pea patch, and he looked at the enemy and gave him one of these. Come on. Not today. Not today. But he stood, amen, and he defended his pea patch. Oh, listen, glory to God. Somebody needs to confess, not today, devil. Not today, devil. Listen, the water's troubled. God is in this place. Amen, hallelujah. God is in this place. And if we, amen, if we will, amen, come faithfully and begin to present that word and that sword of the Lord, I believe a miracle is going to happen. I believe a miracle is going to happen. The Bible said that Paul and Silas, while in prison, they began to rejoice. They began to praise. They begin to glory God, glorify God. And then there is the word suddenly. Suddenly, things happen. In other words, that duet turned into a trio. And God stepped in and started singing with them. Hallelujah. And the chains fell off. The shackles fell. The doors opened. And they were set free. Glory to God. Church, listen, if you need a miracle from the Lord, as they begin to sing this again, I want you to come this morning. And I want men and women of faith, those who know, amen, that God is a healer, that God is a deliverer, that God is a healer. I want you to come around these altars, and I want you to cry out to God, that God will begin to pour his virtue upon these that need miracles today. If you need a miracle today, come here. Amen. Come. Hallelujah. He's here. Glory to God. And I believe suddenly the power of God is going to be released upon your life. Because we're going to swing the sword this morning. We're going to swing that sword. Come on, church. Come on, let's get involved. Hallelujah. And let's see what great things God will do in this house this morning. Hallelujah. Sing it, listen.
Hear our cry, be lifted high in this place. Lord, we want you, no one else will do in this place.
Hear our cry.
Lord, hear our cry, be lifted high in this place. Lord, we want you, no one else will do in this place.
Are broken, eyes are open,
Chains are broken.
are citizens of the kingdom of God. We are not of this world, but we are of the kingdom. We're of the kingdom. You see, this world deals with fact. It deals with fact. You see, the fact may be that you're sick. The fact may be that your marriage is messed up. The fact may be this, and it may be that. But we don't deal with the fact. The fact has no power over us because we're children of the Most High God. We deal with truth. We deal with truth. And so when you receive the fact, you need to get the truth of the matter. Hallelujah. Get the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Hallelujah. From the fact, glory to God. The truth is what changes our lives. The truth is what mentors us and molds us. The truth is what establishes us as a blood-bought, spirit-filled child of God. Hold on to the truth. Hallelujah. Or you may be going through the fact. You may have received the diagnosis. But glory to God. The truth of the matter is with His stripes you are healed. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. Hallelujah. I believe there's been some miracles take place in this house today. I believe. I tell you, do you believe in miracles? Amen. Do you believe in miracles? I believe in the miracle working power of the Lord Jesus Christ. You know why? Because look right here. I'm here today. I'm here today. Those of you that walked with me through in those storms, you knew all about it, and you know I'm a miracle. Sister JoJo, you're a miracle. You're a miracle, girl. Amen, you're a miracle. Sister Jane, you're a miracle. You're a miracle. Amen. Listen, the world would have thrown them away a long time ago. Oh, they've got this. They've got that. Baloney. They got the Word of God. They got the truth. They got the truth. They got the truth. Glory to God. I believe as it was told unto me, and I therefore speak. As even I believe, and I speak. Amen. And I confess. Listen, get that sword. Amen. Get that sword. Swing that sword until the sword gets a hold of you and you get an attitude of faith and you say, come on, come on, I got something for you. Hallelujah. Praise God. Glory to God. I believe we've been in heaven today. Amen. I believe we've been in heaven. Give the Lord a big, big thank you. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. Glory to God. Amen. Well, praise the Lord. Thank you for your faithfulness to the house of God. And be sure and be faithful to prayer meeting tonight. I believe God honors our prayers, don't you? I believe He honors our prayers. I believe He just gets a big old pudding smile on His face every time 6 o'clock Sunday evening comes. My church is corporately praying. Glory. Real glory. Thank you for your faithfulness. Would you stand and lift your hands for the blessing of the Lord? May the Lord bless you and keep you, His face shine upon you and His countenance be lifted upon you. And because it's written His name upon you, these blessings shall come upon you and overtake you. I speak the blessing of Obed-Edom upon you, that everything that pertains to you and your household is blessed in this day and in this economy. May your dollar spend like 500,000. In Jesus' name, we love you and we appreciate you. Amen and amen. Hallelujah.
Ooh, that preaching was real hot.
We heard you, though. I think you about preached the battery away.
I love when...